In the summer of 2012, Tom Livingstone and Tom Ripley flew out to Alaska to attempt a new route on one of the subsidiary faces of Denali, the highest mountain in North America. Unfortunately, they did not attempt the new route for a number of reasons. They did, however, make perhaps the youngest ever British ascent of the Cassin Ridge, which tops out on Denali.
Let's go skiing! Alright! Sled hauling success. Base camp about 5 hours ago. We just passed 7,600 meter camp. 7,600 foot camp even, just down there. I'm now halfway up a horrible feature called Ski Hill.
This is one of two loads that we're having to carry up this hill. We've decided probably a red or a black run to ski down it.
Bullshit.
Mainly because we might die from the crevasses.
I like rucksacks more than sledges.
How you find that pink slat living bed?
Oh, it's great fun.
Sweet.
It's the most fun I've ever had.
Mess it up.
Oh crikey.
There's our cooker and our sleeping area. Tom sleeps on the left, I sleep on the right. This is the little food larder.
What's in here then? Show us.
This is more food than Will Hardy has ever eaten.
Yes. Snickers bars and
Mott's and Mountain House.
Yes.
Nice mixture of Jelly Bellies and Skittles.
Awesome.
And then we got my kit bag, our skis, the solar panel, and the poo shed.
The igloo, also known as the poo shed at the moment. Glorious.
The Livingstone guide to brushing your teeth on a glacier with no water. Ta-da!
Okay, mate, what's just happened?
Well, basically, I've just discovered that my piss bottle has a hole in it.
Oh, no.
So I've had a piss, and then the piss has emptied straight out the piss bottle and onto my mat. Those special Nalgene piss bottles that we paid $11 for are shit. Well, no,
La 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 la. Cleaning up my piss in Alaska. La 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 la. Cleaning up my piss in Alaska. La 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 la.
Just lols.
Post hauling on the way to the Cassin.
She said, call me now, baby. I come up running. She said, call me now, baby. I come up running.
Here we are at the base of the Cassin on Friday. Here is the Cassin. It goes up that couloir there and then up the skyline. And we've come down there, big scary glacier, today.
Just past 5 o'clock in the morning. We're at the bottom of the Japanese couloir.
Blisters, man. I'm having blisters. Have you got any holes in your pants?
We are at the top of the knife edge ridge. We left at 6:30?
No, 6 a.m. So
6 a.m. And it's 6. At 12. So it's taken us 6 hours to do this.
Yeah.
Which is good. This is 2,000 feet.
Only got another.
Only got another 6,000 to go.
Whoop, whoop, whoop.
Whoa.
When you say 2,000 metres, it doesn't sound quite as far. And then you realise 2,000 metres vertical is a fucking long way.
Yeah.
Woohoo!
Some great view.
Now in the Bergsund at the top of the Hang Glacier, bottom of the second rock band. Just got the really loud petrol stove on, which is amazing because we're both really thirsty. Tom's flying a glove for us. And hopefully, we're going to drink lots of water and keep on climbing. Pretty tired.
Yeah.
Platform, isn't it?
Yep, this is the small bivvy. At what altitude are we at? 15 a bit? 16? Dunno. Well, we're between the first and second rock bands.
Tonight, partly cloudy, with a low at 17,000 feet of -5. Summit winds, south to 25. Tomorrow, for above 14,000 feet, snow up to 6 inches, with a high temperature at 17,000 of 5 degrees, with summit winds south 25 to 35 miles per hour.
We just gotta go.
Okay, so we finally called it a day for night. We're at about 16,500 feet. We've got our little tent on this very precarious ledge. It's about one in the... Thankfully we've got a good belay. I'm just melting water, a hot water. It's about one in the morning. Tom's in bed because he's a lazy shit. Not really. Tom's feeding the cat for tomorrow.
Been rope gun.
Yeah, he's been a hero, rope gun in the last bit. And I think we're going to go to sleep, and then hopefully we should get to talk tomorrow. Otherwise, we'll be very hungry.
So here we are in the upper ridge of the Cassin. We've just come from all the way down there, the lowest point you can see. Pretty much like a 1,000 feet boot pack just then. Good effort, man. But we've got plenty of altitude left to go. What's the altitude are we at now? 18.5, 18.6. And we're just getting a litre of water each, a bit of food. Cracking on to the top. You know, I'm just feeling celebration tonight. Celebrate, don't wait too late.
So it's about 9 o'clock in the evening. We're nearly at the top of the Cassin Ridge, we think. I think we're at about 19,000 feet, but hopefully it might be a little bit higher. And it's bloody gorgeous. Forager and Hunter and some other stuff up there, what's it called? And Living Bone climbing up really slowly. Whew. What a route, eh? Hopefully we should get to the top in about an hour or two. Woohoo! This is Tom.
This is Uli.
Hello.
And this is Denali. Denali, Denali.
Tell you to run. Oh boy. Oh boy. The moment is here, moment is young. Well, pick me up. Well, I would like to hold my little hand. I will be right there.
Play the song, play the song.
Ah! It's that way.
Oh. Morning!
Look,
we get flown out in an hour.
Get me a fucking baby bottle and I might start being cheerful.
How long have you been in bed for?
Half an hour.
And you've been a little mess of shit that he wants. Oh, baby bell. Oh. Soft. Dearie me. What's your obsession with baby bell?
They're fucking lush. It tastes like a...
We're gonna have to edit that bit out.
Yeah, Nick and I might not be happy with that bit.
No, I don't think so. You disgust me.
Get me a fucking baby bell.
No, get out of bed.
Fucking get me a baby bell.
We've gotta go up there to fly out.
Maybe they did.
It's Ace of Bates. I remember this. Wait for it. It goes on for quite a while, doesn't it? I'm glad we could edit this. This is some of the moves. You better watch out. If we're in Tarquino.
I don't think they play Ace of Base in Tarquino.
We will request it. We will request it.
When I was in there.